busy city. You can't really identify who's a veteran, who's homeless on the streets of New York. The only time to do that is in the middle of the night. At 4 o'clock in the morning, you come outside. The only people that are there are the people that are homeless. I'm very proud to say that we've had a significant impact there. I mean, when we first started, there were several hundred homeless veterans living at Newark Penn Station. We're now under 30. Many of those people have been housed.
GI Go runs a stand down for homeless vets event that draws hundreds of veterans and offers food, clothing, checkups, jobs, and legal assistance. Today, veterans like 28-year-old Deshaun Moore are GI Go's focus. Moore is now going to college, something he never thought about doing, and living in a single-family home with his wife and twin boys.
Well, I was, you know, pretty much homeless, like living with, you know, trying to live with in-laws. Like, we were pretty much, me and my wife, my twin boys, we were living out of our conversion van. Currently, I live in a one-family home. Two-bedroom with a loft. It has a backyard, a garage, basement. Like, it's, you know, decked out, you know, family-ready.
Robert Lyons, an Army veteran from Desert Storm, worked in the Newark Public Schools as a security guard for 12 years, but is looking to advance his career.
I'm hoping for a lot of things. He just gave me this brochure here about Vet Pro, and it's basically a program you create your own now, as you do a variety of things for people like mountain TVs or assembling furniture, and it's room for advancement and good pay.
I help veterans basically with employment, their education needs, if they need to file a claim, anything that will make them more marketable or anything that could, you know, get them ahead in life.
Lawrence and Stacy Wood are married, both former Marines. They are currently working part-time but want full-time positions.
I served in Yuma, Arizona from 2000 to 2004, United States Marine Corps. I was with a squadron called MOTS 1. It stood for Marine Aviation Weapons and Tactics. What I did basically was I took care of the logs and records, the weight and balance for the aircraft, the fixed and rotorway.
I served from 1997 to 2011. I served in Okinawa, which was one of my first duty stations, and then primarily in Camp Lejeune, North Carolina. I deployed in 2007 to Iraq. GI Fund, they assisted me with updating my resume, resources and stuff, being new to New Jersey. I'm working nights at FedEx Ground, and why I'm obtaining my education at the University of Phoenix online.
For many of these veterans, as long as they served 3 or more years, what makes them more marketable is a chance to get a free education and a monthly stipend through the GI Bill. They can also choose from 200 training courses online at jobs.gigo.org. 21,000 new applicants each month log on looking for resume help and training.
Oftentimes, we'll take a veteran's resume, which is in terrible format, and really turn it around and put it in the correct format, really help them tell the story of who they are, so that they really have a shot at finding work.
More job training will be available in New Jersey and around the country, thanks to a new technology center partnership with Panasonic.
The GI Go Fund is building a training center, and we're helping equip with technologies to help support our military partners and veterans to help transition them into the workforce, right? Giving them the skills they need, the training they need to make it easier for them.
Panasonic wants to help train veterans for a number of reasons.
They have great motivation and determination. You know, people in the military are very good at working together as teams, and I think that's very helpful in being in a collaborative environment.
It's a challenge to translate and to really get to keep line of communications open, and that's what really we advocate for, is to the employers to educate them and help them understand exactly what veterans bring to the table and how some of the skill sets they brought home with them from the military can actually benefit their place of work. They're real leaders, and that leadership can really help a place of business.
What an incredible organization. Certainly they've got their work cut out for them, but I know the veterans that are getting the help they need are so appreciative. All right, let's check in with meteorologist Dan Zarrow.
Hey, it's cold. I hope that the veterans could get this information I'm going to get right now so they could better themselves, because they deserve the best in the world. They deserve the best in America, because they serve our great country, and they should be living good, not like this, coming home with low jobs, payment. They should be getting the best. I hope Trump will help them better. Veterans need to get better jobs. I hope Trump could see my video so that he could really help them. Thank you. It's the 718 Ricardo Perro from the Boogie Down South Bronx. So I hope this information is good for them. Thank you. Yeah.